fly to Florida, fly to Haiti, and then in order to get to Loganov, which is the island that this school is on, you could take a boat or from Port-au-Prince, the capital of Haiti, could take a boat, or if you are very, very lucky, you could take a plane. But as you can see, it's quite a journey. And we are so lucky that today we have Samuel Michel. He is the director of the school that the Hungry Tummies program supports. The school is called Friends of the Children, that's the translation, and he is here to talk about the partnership that Crane School can have with his school in Loganov.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you. So, I am very happy to be here and part of you, like in brothers and sisters. I think when I see all the kids, I feel like happy because this is what I'm doing on the island. And a little short song, which we try to teach the little kids, it's a little song that I can try and see if I can sing it. Eh? Would you like that?
Yeah!
let's try, and if you know it, we can, just 1 minute, eh? We can just do it together. One little boy, little six, little H. Do you know that?
Yeah.
One little, two little, three little Haitian.
Four little, five
little, six little Haitian.
Seven
little, eight little, nine little Haitians. 10 little Haitian boys. Is that good?
Yeah.
So this song, I teach this little song to the kid. So today I'm here to talk to you about the CSAE school and what is the connections we are trying to put together with Crane School. In our little school on the island where Edward was talking to you about, is sitting in the middle of the island where the first town is. We call the first town Ansagale. So this town is about 45 minutes by boat from the mainland. And this town or the island has been forgotten by the government. So everything we need to fly or take a boat to get it, like food, everything. Before I told you that, I should thank first Hayward, Grail, the principal of the school, all the family's member, and the old student that take time to come and listen to me. So thank you. So you can see here, that's exactly the logo of the organizations that we have in 2002 and bring the school in 2014. So we have this school building by our friend in Australia. And you see this little blondie, the lady, Alana, she's not there today because she's working. So we built the school by the founding from Australia. Now in the school we have 116 students. They come every day and their age is from 2.5 years old to 5 to 6. This is a kindergarten school. And you can see me with a short pant and a little beret up on top of my head, because you know, here I am here for a surgery. We are trying to grow these connections with Crane. It's already a big school, and I learned a lot from this, going to the garden, going to the bathroom, going to the class, and talking to teachers and talking to friends and kids here, like a little warbird. So we call it warbird. But my friend when I have just met him. We call him little because I feel big than him. So he is my brother. And like I have my sister Grell and our moms Grell and Hayward. This is my pleasure to be here and to talk to you. The most important thing I want to tell you that the school into the island is one of the schools we are trying to promote permaculture and trying to talk to people how to become a self-sufficient. This kind of things are not so easy to find the big, how can I say that, the big means to design people, to join people there. But with the kids, they represent the future. We can start the garden with the kids. We can teach them how they can grow and become a self-sufficient. By this way, I think the connection with Crane School can be a good design and a good connection. It's not easy to have things done in the world because of relationship. Creating a relationship between different school or different people with different culture, it's meant a lot of things. But here, we're trying to make it easy because we think in the human right, we have one goal, to change the world. If you come to school and you fight everything, and there is other kids in the world that can't even go to school. So we're trying to create this one to bring the kids that couldn't have access to go to school. And now we have many, many things happen because of you and many other people that try to help in this case. The island called it Laguna. We call Laguna. And I'm sorry, I don't have the pictures of Laguna here. You have it? So I can show you, like Howard said, we have this little island, like you see here, right here. And this is, this is the island. And this is where we are from the coast. And you come here from Port-au-Prince to here where the dock is. And then over here, we have the school. So you can fly or you can take a boat. You can fly 5 people, 6 people, because they're not a big plane. But you can be on a boat, like 200 or 250. So this is where we stay. Everybody goes to Haiti. Most of them, they stay there. But we are here. We have a Wesleyan hospital when the kids has problem, and then we bring them there for a self-care or first aid. So I don't have a lot of time to like talking. It's a short presentation because Howard will tell you, we have the Hungry Tummy program, I think. That you can see my t-shirt, said Hungry Tummy program. We cannot have school where the kids have all those problems and without solving food problem. Food problem is one of the main things. And then, you know, without food, without a stable mind, you cannot talk about education. Thank you.
Okay, so here are some of the kids. We have seen some of the kids at Sam's school. And what he didn't tell you, and what I think is so great to talk about just in relation to Kate's culture or current event when she was talking about when you are looking to help abroad, what do you want to do? Do you just want to go and say, oh, we're here, we're help, we're going to do what we want to do? No, you want to find and you want to work with a community leader, and Sam is that community leader. Before he built his school, he was running an organization to do this permaculture, so it's not agriculture where they clear the land and plant crops. It's finding ways to grow those crops with the shade of the trees, the ones that need to be by the stream. So he's doing that. He's running computer classes for adults. He is then it grew to build the school because he, like he said, you guys are the future, and in every country in the world, the children are the future. So we've seen some of these pictures. This is the food that Hungry Tummies is providing, because for a lot of these kids, it's really different. This might be the only meal that they have for the day. So we know we're doing a good thing because we're working right with a community leader and we're doing the direct need, fulfilling the direct need. Now our goal as a school that we set in service learning is to raise $2,500 for this organization. Why do we want to raise $2,500? We want to do that because we have a generous donor who is willing to match this fund if we get to our goal. And if we get to our goal and have the matching fund, we will feed the children of the school for the entire school year. So that means that when they get to school, they're going to have a really nice breakfast and they're going to be engaged and ready to learn. Quickly, just a couple ways for us, I want to put it in perspective, okay? How many of you tap your head if you have had a piece of pizza from Whole Foods? After school snack, maybe quick dinner on the run. I know I have, my kids have. It's $3.50. In the school in Loganoff, our dollar goes so far and 14 children get breakfast for that $3.50. So that's 14 bowls of curry and rice. That could be 14 bowls of oatmeal and soup, or maybe it's cornflakes, whatever it is that they're serving today. You can just see in the difference of how far our dollar goes. We're gonna help, right? We're gonna start this coin drive, a donation drive today, and I just quickly wanna help you think about ways that you can contribute. Not your parents, although they are totally welcome to contribute, but you. So tap your head again if you have an allowance that you divide, maybe some for spending, maybe some for savings, and maybe some to help others. Does anyone have one of those? Seems like quite a few of you do, at least half. So when you're thinking about who you might want to help with your helping, you can think of this. And then lastly, does anyone do any help around the house that they get paid for, any chores? Yeah? Okay, so you can think about that money, or maybe think specifically, I have an extra job. What can I do that's an extra job? So just in closing, I would like you to know that we are starting our coin drive tomorrow, or dollar drive. You will see these in your classroom. Mental math, for those of you that want to do it, we have $1,500 to meet our goal. We have 250 students, roughly. So you can think about how much you might want to bring in if you think our whole student body could reach that goal. That would be $6 a student. And just remember, tomorrow's Valentine's Day. So when you're thinking of spreading love and spreading happiness, maybe think about bringing in a couple dollars to help our school meet our goal to help the school in Loganoff. Thank you.